Hello, Holden Chapel Kids. I don't know about you, but I love to hear stories from the Bible about God's faithfulness to His people, because it reminds me of all the ways that God shows His faithfulness to us. I also love to sing about God's faithfulness as a way to worship and praise God for all He has done. Let's worship Him in song right now.
The God I serve knows only how to
it's activity time. Today's activity is called Tall Tower. For this activity, you will need blocks or other stackable materials. You can get creative here. You can use dominoes, boxes, toilet paper. You will also need a timer. First, divide the building materials among your family members. Set the timer for 2 minutes and see who can build the tallest tower before the time is up. When that is done, combine the building materials and reset the timer. This time, work together to build the tallest tower possible. Pause the video while you complete this activity, then press play when you are ready. Have fun! How did you do? Were you able to build the tallest tower? Were you able to build a taller tower when you worked alone or when you worked together? God sometimes calls us to do difficult things that we can't do on our own, but God always gives us what we need. Today we will hear the story of how God used Nehemiah to lead his people as they rebuilt Jerusalem's walls. No one could rebuild the walls on their own. The people needed to work together to complete this huge task.
Nehemiah went to Jerusalem to help the people rebuild the city walls. The people started working together to fix the walls and the burned down gates. The walls and gates had special names. Some of the people worked on the fish gate. The fish gate was the entrance to the fish market. Some people worked on the sheep gate. This gate led to the place men gathered to sell sheep. Others worked on the valley gate, the old gate, and the horse gate. The workers put in doors, bolts, and bars. They cut stones and lifted them into place on the wall, and they filled in gaps and holes. All around the city, people worked side by side. Soon, the wall was half as tall as it had once been. Not everyone was happy that Jerusalem's walls were being rebuilt. Some men who lived nearby were angry. Sanballat and Tobiah mocked the people. Sanballat said, "What do these people think they are doing? These walls are just piles of trash and dirt. They can't be rebuilt." Nehemiah prayed. God's people kept working on the walls, but their enemies made a plan to attack them and stop their work. God's people prayed and assigned men to guard the walls all day and all night, but they were discouraged. "Our enemies are everywhere," they said. Nehemiah reminded the people that God was with them. "Do not be afraid. God is great and powerful," Nehemiah said. "Be ready. If our enemies attack us, God will fight for us." Sanballat and Tobiah could threaten God's people, but they could not make God's people stop building. Sanballat and Tobiah were not in charge of rebuilding the wall. God was. So God's people went back to work. Some stood guard with weapons and others worked on the wall. Some men worked with one hand and held a weapon in the other. They were always ready to fight, just in case. Nehemiah was a wise and good leader of God's people while they worked. He helped them solve any problems they had, and he did not give in to their enemies. The people kept working very hard. In just 52 days, the wall was complete. The gates were repaired, and the wall was restored. When all of Jerusalem's enemies heard that the wall had been rebuilt, they were afraid because they knew God was with his people. Nehemiah led the people to rebuild the walls around Jerusalem to protect them from their enemies. Jesus came to protect us from our enemies. He died on the cross and rose from the dead to rescue people from sin and death.
Let's dig into God's Word and find out what God wants us to learn from this story. After each question is read, Pause the video and talk about your answers together. Then press play when you are ready. First question. Do you always work hard at the jobs you have to do? Are you tempted to take shortcuts or stop before you have finished the task? How do you feel when you work hard and complete something? Why should we try to do our best at everything we do? God wants us to work hard and do the right things as an act of worship to Him. Colossians 3:23 says, "Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord, not for men." Nehemiah knew that the people in Jerusalem were in danger because the walls and gates were destroyed. If the people didn't work together to rebuild them, their enemies could easily attack them. Nehemiah encouraged the people to work hard and work together to rebuild the walls and gates. And they were able to fix the walls around the entire city in just 52 days. Nehemiah 6:16 tells us that their enemies were intimidated and lost their confidence, for they realized that this task had been accomplished by God. It sounds like their enemies realized the people were working for God and God was working for them. Next question. Have you ever felt afraid or discouraged? What did you do? Did someone help you? When the enemies planned to attack and the people were afraid and discouraged, rather than giving in to fear, Nehemiah prayed for God to take care of them. Then he reminded the people that God was with them and would fight for them. God faithfully answered Nehemiah's prayers. When we are afraid or discouraged, we can follow Nehemiah's example by praying and talking to God. We can trust God to help us because God is always faithful. In addition to prayer, we need friends like Nehemiah who can remind us of God's faithfulness. Hebrews 4:12-13 tells us, "See to it, brothers, that none of you has a sinful, unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God, but encourage one another daily." Let's pray. God, thank you for showing us your faithfulness through the story of Nehemiah. When they were afraid and discouraged, you were faithful to protect them. Remind us of your faithfulness and help us to trust you when we are afraid or discouraged. Amen.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. Christ alone.